Welcome everyone to a level 2 Starbase guide. In this guide, we're gonna talk about all sorts of new available buildings, new units, and the combos that we have. Here are the buildings available to us at level 2 Starbase. So, when we go to training camp, we're gonna see one new unit. This one is called Kamikaze. So what this unit does is that when you deploy the unit, it's gonna target the nearest enemy wall it sees. But if there are no walls at all, that means it's gonna target the nearest building or a unit. And once it reaches its target, the unit dies, but it deals huge damage. And generally, the way this unit is used is to deploy them first to break a wall, because walls, especially highly upgraded walls, have ton of HP. These units can usually one-shot any sort of wall, even if they're highly upgraded. And generally, this unit is not used at all, like hardly ever. But if you would like to use this unit, then the best case for you would be to deploy these units at first so that you can kill the wall, and then you can deploy the rest of your units that would be otherwise blocked by the enemy wall. Other than that, we have new military building, which is called Factory. What Factory does is that it trains vehicles. At this moment, we have two available vehicles at Starbase level 2. One is Strikes, and the second one is Beetle Tanks. So the way Strikes work is that they target anything, any ground unit or building. They go towards the unit, then they go around the unit or the building, and they shoot once or multiple times depending on their fire rate, because right now the fire rate of this unit is really low, but once we upgrade this unit, that means the unit is gonna be able to fire towards the target multiple times. Our secondary unit is Beetle Tanks. Same as Strikes, this unit targets anything on the ground, but it's not able to target any flying units. And the way these units are usually used as is to be frontliners, tank all the damage, because that's what they're best at, and allow the units behind them to deal the damage. So in terms of new resource buildings, we have an additional silo, an additional bank, and a few more mines and compact houses. And also, as we can see, we have an additional warp gate. Here is the graph of how far we can upgrade each building at this level. So, in terms of defensive power, we don't get any additional bunkers, but what we do get is some more turrets, walls, and traps. We have only 30 pieces of wall available to us and only 5 traps. So as we can see, right now we are still not that strong, we don't have any additional bunkers and our turrets are still kinda weak. So it would be still difficult for us to deal with enemy attacks since we are highly relying on our friends' bunker still because we don't have our own bunker just yet. That becomes available to us at level 3, but we do have some traps, and they do enough damage to basically one-shot anything at this level, or at least do severe damage at a point where our turrets can basically one-shot the units, because they take 2000 damage from the traps, and most of the units don't even have 2000 HP at this level. So hopefully, we can use this little defensive power that we have so that we can deal with any sort of attack at this level. If we take a look at the turrets, we're gonna see that we have 3 cannon blasts and 3 sniper turrets available to us at this level. But at this level, our cannon's range is still very short and they cannot reach over the buildings. So we just have to stick with the same strategy and position our sniper turrets behind the buildings while we have our cannons somewhere towards the edge. But regardless of that, I still chose to not follow that rule because our base is still really weak and I would rather sacrifice some buildings so that I can have better defensive power because my turrets are positioned close to the base and most of them are still in the range of each other, which makes the defense a bit more powerful. And speaking of defensive power, we are seeing that I have my walls built around my turrets, which is a really good way to use walls. Generally, the best way to use walls is either to position them around the turrets or around bunkers, because both of them need to be defended so that they can defend you against the attacker. And in terms of traps, we can put our traps wherever, but most of the times they're gonna prove to be useful if you position them somewhere around the center, but not out of your base, because if you position them around your base, like outside, that means that you're basically guessing where the enemy is gonna attack from, and if you guess it the wrong way, that means your traps are gonna be useless because the enemy is never gonna come in contact with the traps. But if you have every single one of your traps inside your base, somewhere around the center, that means that at some point the enemy is gonna walk over the traps, and your traps are gonna be always useful, even if they don't provide as big of a value, because if you have traps around your base like this, basically inside but around the center, it's usually really beneficial because you're gonna make the use of all of your traps and they always gonna hit something. So enough talk about the defenses, and let's see what is available to us in terms of attacking power and which unit combos can we use. Big surprise, we can only use one combo here, which is Beetle Tanks and Bazookas. This combo is one of the strongest ones at low levels, even at like Starbase level 3 or maybe 4. The power of this combo is that Beetle Tanks can tank a lot of damage. They don't deal that much damage themselves, but they allow all the bazookas behind them to deal the damage because bazookas have really high range, as we already know. They have good damage, good range, whereas our Beetle Tanks have very little damage, very little range, but they have ton of HP, which we need for our bazookas because they have very low HP themselves, and basically what they need is for something to tank the damage, which is the reason why the Beetle Tanks are really useful. And as we are seeing right now in the background, if you use your combo in the right way and if you deploy right units at the right time, and I really want to emphasize deploying units at the right time, because even if you blindly deploy all of your units, and yeah, that is usually the way it works, because rushing in with all of your army and just dealing ton of damage at once, yeah, that is really useful most of the times, but those little details where you deploy right units at the right time, if you figure out how it works, if you can make the enemy turrets or bunkers, by bunkers I mean the units inside the enemy bunkers, switch to that unit because vehicles take priority over the ground units. So if anything is targeting your units and then you deploy a vehicle, that unit or a turret is gonna switch to your vehicle. So for example, if you let the enemy turret or enemy units target your bazookas once or twice, which is usually enough to kill your bazookas, but if you wanna min-max sometimes and just be as efficient as possible with your units, then you should consider keeping some of your Beetle Tanks and not deploy them right away, because their job is not to deal damage, their job is to tank the damage, and you want them to tank the damage at the right time. An example would be that if you have 20 bazookas, and if only 2 or 3 of them are gonna get killed by the enemy turrets, then it might not be worth for you to use those few Beetle Tanks that you're gonna have just to keep 2 or 3 bazookas alive, cause in the long run, you might come across a situation where all the 17 of your other bazookas might walk in enemy turret fire range at some point, and if you don't have any Beetle Tanks there, all of your bazookas are gonna die because they have really low HP, which is usually the best time to deploy your Beetle Tanks because they make the enemy turrets switch the fire onto them instead of bazookas or any other ground unit that is not a vehicle. Other than that, if you wanna know whether strikes are strong enough or not at this level, then let me tell you that they are basically so useless at this level that literally any other unit can be better than strikes. And the whole point of having bunch of strikes is that you can deploy them at once, and just having this swarm of strikes just makes the attack really powerful, which we're gonna cover in the later episodes, but right now, strikes are basically useless and they should not be used ever. But they do become one of the strongest units at higher levels, so stay tuned for future guides so that we can see how powerful our strikes can be. And that's basically all we can talk about in this guide, because there's barely anything new at this level, and again, we're gonna spend very little time at level 1 and level 2 star bases, and once we progress, then it's gonna take way many more resources, more time, and more of everything, and at some point, we're gonna reach a point where we're gonna need an additional type of materials to upgrade our star base, and we're gonna need colonies and such. I'm gonna cover those episodes a bit more, and yeah, that's basically all for this guide. Hope you guys enjoyed, stay tuned, and I'm gonna see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.